The Preziosi Family. The villa was built by the Preziosi family around 1757. The family were Corsicans who used Malta as an advanced base for their privateering in the Levant. The title Conte Preziosi was given to Giuseppe Preziosi, who was a Corsican privateer who fought on the side of Venice in the War of the Morea and was rewarded with a pension and a knighthood in 1700. In the summer of 1702, Giuseppe entered the Maltese harbor with three large Turkish vessels which had been captured in the Levant. In 1757, the second Count Giovanni Francesco Preziosi was obliged by the Grand Master to dispose of all his silver treasures, as he owed thousands of scudi. The Grand Master ordered an auction of the Count's precious items to repay some of the larger debts. The villa was divided into 10 shares after Luigi Preziosi, son of Giovanni Francesco, died intestate while in possession of the villa in 1852, leaving 10 children. In 1870, the heirs of Count Luigi Preziosi wanted to divide the land and the villa. For this purpose, surveyors were summoned to draw a plan to see and decide if it was viable to split the villa. And it was decided that it wasn't. And so it was sold by auction. The Francia family. In the late 19th century, the villa was bought by Colonel John Lewis Francia, who was married to Teresa Buttigieg. Being one of the leading millers in Malta, Colonel Francia was a target during the riots of the 7th June 1919, which is now marked as a day when Maltese nationalism first surfaced during the British colonial period. The Francias had three children together, and one of them, Lady Blanche, was married to Sir Hugo Mifsud. The Mifsuds died childless. However, one of the Francia siblings, John Baptist Francia, adopted a son, William Nathaniel Fenton. John Francia bequeathed Fenton, amongst other things, the usufruct, during his lifetime, of Villa Preziosi and the surrounding fields. Later, in a will dated the 5th of January 1987, William gave the full ownership of Villa Francia to the state of Malta. In the will, the testator expressed his desire for the villa to be used as a private residence of the Prime Minister of Malta in office. In a further will dated 27th February 1987, Will bequeathed the villa with all of its belongings to the Republic of Malta. Villa Francia was to retain its name. On the 12th August 1998, the government of Malta and the Francia estate reached an agreement, the thrust of which was to unfetter the government of the restrictions placed in the letter will with respect to the use of the villa and its adjoining lands. Villa Francia. Villa Francia is situated in the northern part of Lia and was formerly known as Villa Preziosi. The villa was built in the mid-18th century, when the Baroque style permeated down from the ruling class to the pretentious and wealthy Maltese families. Evidence shows that the villa was not built in its present complete state in one go, with the original building probably serving as a hunting lodge. It can be demonstrated that additions to the building were made up to the second half of the 20th century. Today the villa consists of a two-story building with front and back gardens. On the southern side is a small garden and a building consisting of some rooms attached to the main building. On the northern side, there is a row of rooms overlooking a large stretch of terraced agricultural land, in which is a circular belvedere overlooking Mosta Road. When entering the front garden, one immediately notices the elaborate external staircase with urns at every landing. The main facade includes porthole windows covered with simple iron grille work and decorated with a surrounding frame made of sculptured foliage. The entrance to the ground floor is in the center of the facade within the external staircase. On each facade of the lateral wings is an arched window, each window separated by rusticated pilasters over which are decorative stone urns. The villa is surrounded with gardens on all four sides. Both the front and back gardens are laid out in the formal Baroque style and develop along a central axis towards an architectural focal point. Different colored pebbles encased to form geometrical patterns cover all the paths in the front and back gardens. This method of decoration was common in Italy during the late Baroque period. The Nymphaeum in the back garden was built before the later wings were added to the main body of the villa. In the center is a fountain representing a cherub on a dolphin, blowing into a shell from which the water spouts. The building has a parapet wall decorated with balustrades and a central archway with a bust of a faun on top. The Nymphaeum building houses a large water wheel which is still in a very good condition, although it lacks the buckets that used to collect water from the artesian well. This is the heart of a complex water system that feeds a number of fountains located across the gardens.